things first. I'm all rugged up in my dressing gown because it's freezing. We had so many nice days and then all of a sudden the weather and temperature just dropped and it's now freezing. So thankfully it will heat up a little bit during the day, but it's kind of early in the morning and it's just cold right now. I forgot to bring my curling wand with me, so I'm using this old Vanity Planet hair straightening brush. I have not used a hair straightening brush in such a long time, but they're actually pretty great. It was this for crimping my hair. Those are the two options that I have, so I decided to go with the hair straightening brush. I feel like I'm kind of settling in to being back home. I started a broadcast channel on Instagram and we were talking about like the end of the year and how we're feeling going into the end of the year and, you know, wrapping up 2023 and being able to start 2024 in like a good positive manner kind of thing. And there were a lot of mixed responses from you guys. Like, some people are feeling really good. A lot of people use the word overwhelmed and I was like, I feel that. I have a total mix of feelings right now. Sometimes I'm super motivated and excited and then in the next moment I am like flat and uninspired. And I talked a little bit about this in the broadcast channel, but I think it's possibly a fear of failure. And I'm at this point where I feel like decision paralysis or action paralysis. Honestly, I could be just making up words at this point. I don't really know what I'm saying. But all of a sudden, I don't know what choice to make. I don't know where to start. I don't know what to do first. And I think it's this fear of failure and I'm sort of spiraling and it is definitely not a good headspace to be in. And so now I kind of have to figure out what I can do to pull myself out of this spiral and I don't know, get myself organized and figure out where I'm heading for the, you know, remaining quarter of 2023 so that I can go into 2024 in like a really good headspace, like a positive manner, you know, just the best way possible, really. Can't get this little bump out of the back of my head. I don't know if this is actually gonna be a decent job or not, but it's fine. We're going with it. It's all I've got right now. Anyway, look, I think I'm getting a pretty good morning routine. It's very chill, very like make my coffee and just go sit in the garden for a little bit as the sun comes up. It was a bit cold this morning, but the last few days have been so lovely. So it's just such a nice slow start to the day. And then I come in, get ready or whatever, and then I can start working and whatnot. Today, I have a bunch of errands to run and I kind of made this decision yesterday. The thing about living in the country is I don't usually get to be as spontaneous as what I would like. I have to sort of pre-plan things out. So this morning I've organized with my mom to take the car and go into town and I just need to pick up a few things. I want to go to the hardware and get some paint swatches. I actually have a couple because I went to a hardware near here and I haven't a good idea of what color I want to go for, and I'm just trying to decide whether I bite the bullet and just buy some paint today or whether I, you know, bring home some swatches and try and figure it out. But I've been sitting on this for like 3 days and I think I just need to do it and just get over the decision paralysis and just make a choice. And if it's the worst choice, like, so what? I can repaint the wall as like a worst case scenario, you know? So I think I just have to maybe go for it today. I want to go to Kmart and just have a bit of a look around because I haven't done that in like 6 months. And yep, just gonna try and get a bunch of things done today and hopefully by the end of the day feel like I have a little bit more of a handle on how the spiraling of, you know, not knowing where to start or what to do or how to figure it out. Also, this room is a complete disaster. I did get my coat hangers, but it's so messy in here and I think that's also contributing to the, you know, headspace that I've been in. So we have to clean as well. This is about as good as my hair is gonna get. I don't remember the last time I did like a proper straight hair. The reason I don't normally do straight hair is because it highlights my haircut, which is just this chunk of hair that's not really cut. It's mostly from breakage. And I know it's from breakage because I had all my hair cut off up to here in 2020. And now that it's grown back, I have the exact same thing. I have always just had this big chunk of hair on this side of my head that's shorter than the rest. But you know, I probably should have just crimped it because I have burnt like 3 fingers, well, 2 fingers and my thumb, and that was not a good idea. Okay, next time I'm just gonna crimp it or I'll, you know, invest in a new curling wand or something. Before I finish getting ready, I'm gonna go make some food because I am starving.
Thank you.
My breakfast doesn't look exactly the most appetizing. It's an English muffin cut in half and toasted with a slice of ham, avocado, salt and pepper, and also onion flakes. I've been putting onion flakes on things and I really like it. I also have the teeniest, tiniest amount of coffee left. So I'm gonna eat this and then continue to get ready. One of the reasons I actually want to go to Kmart is because I don't have a full-length mirror and it would be nice to be able to actually see my outfit before I go anywhere, but also it's much easier to show you than me trying to do this and be like, I have my long sleeve TNA shirt on. This is actually like a fitness type shirt, but it's cold and I don't have anything else, so I'm gonna wear this. It's like a cropped shirt. I also have my beige Sloan pants, and then I also have my like cream slides from Nordstrom. And I think because I'm wearing cream slides, I'll just go with my cream YSL bag, but I'm also going to take my black Longchamp tote bag because that's going to be able to carry my groceries and the things that I buy. So I'll take both. I also did half my nails yesterday, so this is the fresh hand. I will do the other hand this afternoon when I get back. It's just such a process that I can kind of do like one hand at a time. So one's done, the other one isn't. What else do I need? Oh, probably a bit of perfume while I'm at it. I have found the mirrors. I kind of want all of them. I think this floor length one here is the only one that's available, and you know what? I think it'll be perfect. It's only 45 bucks, which is a great price for a floor length mirror. And I can't seem to find any other ones. Like, there's these beautiful round ones. This little one's really cute too, but I think this is the only one. So I might grab it and go and put it near the checkout and get them to hold it for me while I keep looking. I'm playing with the idea of color. I love this. I love the vase. I have three bunches of these poppy type fake flowers. I don't know if three is too many, but I really kind of like it. I'm just trying to see what else there is. Maybe I'm getting ahead of myself and I should paint the wall first, but I do think this is really pretty and I want color in my room. I also do like this one with the orange in it. And I feel like if I did the wall and this kind of green, it would just look like so good together. I feel like that ended up being pretty successful. I didn't buy any decor or flowers, although I do think I have a vase at home that would be perfect for those poppy flowers. I'm gonna think about the flowers and that kind of stuff because I do know I have a box at home full of decor and flowers and things like that. And I ended up getting the mirror. Two things for my phone because I took the screen protector off my phone last week and my charger cable also broke while I was on the plane. So I bought one to replace that. And then, oh, I bought a little organizer for my makeup. So we'll see how that goes, whether that fits how I want it to, I don't know, but we'll see. So I feel like that was a good start. I am now gonna head to the hardware store and look at paint. Making some progress. I feel like the one that's on the right hand side is a little too yellow, the one on the left is too blue, and the one in the middle I think is gonna be perfect. I'm just not sure exactly what color, but I feel like dinosaur might be the way to go.
I'm back. I feel like I made some pretty good progress today. I came home with a bunch of stuff that I didn't really think that I needed. And one of those things was a yoga mat. I have this exact same mat already. It's in Toronto. It's only $5 and I couldn't fit my usual one in my suitcase. And I figured I would just grab another one that can stay here for whenever I visit. So I have a new yoga mat. I also grabbed a glass screen protector for my phone and then also a USB-C lightning cable so that I can charge my phone. Because as I mentioned before, when I was on the plane, the guy in front of me moved his seat up. And when he did it, my cord was like, and phone was sitting in the back pocket of the seat, and it just like ended up snapping the little connector piece that goes into the phone, and I had to like try and pull it out. I don't really know why that happened, but it did. So now I have a new cable. This was not on my list either, and I'm kind of excited about this. It's just a little acrylic tray, and I thought I would set it up here on my dresser because I've been doing my makeup the last couple of days in the mirror here on the dresser, and I thought this would be cool to organize my makeup. So I'm gonna do that. I also have a bunch of paint samples and all of that, and of course I bought the mirror as well. No, I just remembered that I still have some other things. I bought some new makeup sponges. These are the Eco Tools plant based blenders. These ones are both green, but they're the exact same. Actually, no, I lie. I don't know where the nude sponge is from, but this little purple one is the purple version of the green one, and I just like a small one for my bronzer and a bigger one for my foundation, and I've had these ones for too long, so they can be thrown out. I'm gonna replace that with these. I also grabbed some toothpaste. I got myself two blocks of chocolate. I got a Turkish Delight, which is like my favorite, and then I also got the snack version as well, which does have some pieces of the Turkish Delight in it, but you know, it's got the pineapple and the strawberry and all those cool flavors. And then the last thing that I grabbed was another little face wash because I am out of the one that I currently have. So very productive. Feel like I ticked off basically everything on my list. I also got cat food, coffee beans, some bread, and just all the bits and pieces that I needed and that were on my list. So yeah, I'm done and I'm excited. As you can tell, it's very, very much a mess in here. I'm going to set up this little acrylic container, you know, go move some of this stuff into the bathroom. These are all of the paint swatches that I ended up picking up and that I was playing with in the store. These are the ones from yesterday, and I was tossing up between these two. So this is a much more a blue green, and this one's a much more of a yellow green. And then I ended up getting a sample of the dinosaur. I'm pretty sure was the first color that I picked out when I looked at the Jewellery website, and I really, really like it. It's not too blue, like these greens are very blue and then these greens are very yellow and very olive. I did have a look in a catalog, and this color right here was painted on a kitchen and it looked amazing. Thought it were just a little too gray, and now I'm not really sure. Like, this is really dark, so I'm gonna play with it. I'll open the pot and show you. This is the color we're working with. It will dry a little bit darker, but I kind of like it. It's almost got a bit more yellow to it than I feel what is here on the sample, which I am so happy about. But I don't know, I feel like I should just go for it and stop worrying about it. And then, like, you know, if I really, really, really hated it, I could always get something that's a little more gray, a little more olive, and paint it again. But I feel like this is just the perfect green, and it, as I said, I think it was the first one I picked, so maybe I should just go with it. Does it look cute or does it look messy? Because I can't decide. I have my foundation, eyelash curler, pencil sharpener, and some eyelashes that I didn't even know I had in the back there. I have lip products in the second drawer, and then I have eye products in the third drawer, or the third section, I don't know. I still need to get a new eyeshadow palette because this is just bad. I dropped it again the other day and lost all of this one, half of the black, and it's just a disaster. Ultimately, I only use these two and maybe some of the middle one and the black one if I'm doing a bit more of a smoky eye, and I need to figure out something else. Maybe even something that's like a 4 eyeshadow palette, something a little more compact, because it's just gross. I'm trying and I'm just knocking everything over. Oh yeah, it's a disaster. I don't think that looks good at all, but it does kind of keep everything together and out of the way. I don't know. What do you think? I have never used a plate, what is it called? An alignment plate when doing a screen protector before, but that was flawless. The only thing is the like package didn't come with the wet wipe or the dry wipe, so I just had to use a paper towel and some Windex, but that worked perfectly. Oh my gosh, it was like $5, $6, $8. I don't know how much it was very cheap, but that's awesome. So happy with that. I feel like it's becoming a very successful day. I'm just gonna take off my pants that I was wearing today and put my gym leggings back on because I'm at home and I just want to be comfortable. I try so hard to wear normal clothes around the house and it just doesn't work with my brain. I just want to be comfortable when I'm at home. I'm also gonna throw some socks on because this concrete floor does make my feet cold. I think I had a couple questions actually about whether the floor is unfinished or not. It's not. It's polished concrete, which is really nice. It's not my cup of tea, but it just can be really cold. So I need to put socks on and wear slippers when I am walking around. Also, I saw a rug today and then this lady like kind of came up and jumped in on it and I wasn't gonna say no, you can't have it because I didn't know if I wanted it. So I let her have it, but it was kind of cool. It was like an oriental rug that was sort of a pinky orangey tone. So I'm not sure, but I've totally given up on the whole rug thing. Don't even ask me about it because I can't think about it right now. I need to clean. I need to clean this room and then I can unbox this mirror and figure out where I'm gonna put it.
It's really messy in here. I don't think I've ever showed my space being so messy before. So I have a lot to clean and a lot to organize and I'm gonna do that. And then, you know, clear space means clear mind and I can get in to do some other things. Enough. It's not perfect. Like I didn't even really make the bed properly because I know that I'm going to change the bedding to something else and I'm going to pull the bed out very soon, like maybe tomorrow or the next day to paint the wall anyway. But I did clear up some of the bedside table. This is just some stuff that I've stuck in the corner that I need to deal with. My wardrobe is kind of done. It's still a work in progress. This is going to take me some time. And then the space behind me is okay, I guess. Like I still need to sort things out. I don't know what I'm going to do about that makeup. And then this is my nail kit and all of my nail stuff that I will do later this evening so I can do my right hand. And then here is my mirror, which I really like. I think it is a great mirror. I just don't know if I'm going to leave it against the window. I mean, like the lighting's so great when it's against the window, right? And it's really great for like outfit photos, videos, all that kind of thing. I may end up moving it next to the bed, but I do love it. I'm really glad that I got it and I can't believe it was only $45. Like that's so cheap for a full length mirror. So Kmart coming through again. Anyway, I need to get in and do some like admin work and stuff this afternoon. First thing I'm working on today is creating two custom currency planners. I need to do a Russian one and a Georgian one. And this one right here is a new green one. I launched this yesterday. It's in a beautiful foresty green kind of vibe. And if you use the code YouTube20, you can get 20% off anything and I'll have a link down below to it. But this one I think is my new favorite. I love green. It's my favorite color. And I just think that this design is such a vibe. It kind of matches everything that's going on in my life. I've got my little green tumbler, my little green paint chips over there. Everything is just green. We're living in a green world. So I'm gonna do these two custom currency planners and get them sent off to the customer. And then I think I'm gonna do some stuff for my visa, which is just pure admin and it's super boring. I have like nothing to share on in regards to that, but it's just a lot of like collecting information.
I'm done with that for now. I am going to finish off my nails. I had to put my jumper on because it's kind of cold and I'm also using my big dressing gown as a blanket. I don't know where my mom got these from, but they're fabulous. The brand's Cheetah, C-I-T-T-A. I actually am not sure, but they're just so soft and cozy and it's such a long one that it goes all the way to the ground and I love it. I'm gonna need to go and get some warm water so I can soak my nails and push back all of the cuticles. So right now I have this like pink color on them. I was doing dip powder for such a long time and I did my nails last week just before my cousin's wedding because she has an even bigger dip powder collection than I do. But I took it off before while I was just taking a break and now I'm just doing gel polish. My nails are so much more like prone to breaking with just gel polish, but I find it easier and I'm just kind of over having like thicker nails. I kind of like that they're thin and not as chunky, and they're still long and they're totally fine. I mean, give it a few days, they'll probably all be broken, but it's fine. I don't mind having short nails now, so I don't know. I guess the vibe has changed. I just came back with some paper towel for my bowl of warm water to soak my nails, and I realized I actually haven't cleaned the mirror, so we're gonna do that. Also, please don't judge my little socks and slippers situation. Believe me, it's very, very comfortable and it's much needed because it's way, way too cold. I'm not gonna lie, this is way too hard trying to hold my camera and do it at the same time. Here's my little bowl of warm water. I have my paper towel to dry them on, and then I have my cuticle pusher, so I use this to push back all the cuticles, and then I also have my cuticle cutter thingy, whoops, cuticle scissor cutter thingy as well, and then basically I'm gonna go straight into painting after that because I already filed them into shape. I had to turn the big light on because it was starting to get really dark in here. I'm trying to find the top coat. Where did I put it? Anyways, I bought this big pack of gel polish colors back in the pandemic. I will try and link it down below. There's so many different colors. There's pinks and blues and greens and yellows. It's got literally everything. There we go. There's a top coat. I have the base coat, and then I also have, this is the pink color. Why won't you focus? And this is the pink color that I have currently on my nails. So I'm gonna do this. Oh, and I also have the proper lamp. The one that I've been using in my travels is just like a little USB portable one, which is great for, you know, traveling around, but these actual lamps are just so much better. My nails are complete. They're not the neatest, but hey, they'll do. Definitely think I prefer this hand. I think this hand looks better, but I am gonna go outside and go for a bit of a walk before it gets dark and gets into the evening.
The sun has started to set. I just figured I would come out here for a bit of a walk. You can see how dry and crunchy it is. It's really bad. It's so dry going into like bushfire season. It's not good. Like, it's really not good. This is my tree. Oh, I can hear my cat. I heard him meow. I'm gonna find him in a second. But this is my tree, this really big tree. It doesn't look big from where I'm standing, but trust me, when we walk up to it, it's really big. My dad assigned a tree to me when I was a little kid, and it was this one. And you can see, yeah, see, look, the closer I get, the bigger it gets. Like, it is a really big tree, and I think that's some kangaroos making some noise. Anyway, you can see all of like the charred bottom of it, just for like foot size. There's my foot, there's the tree. But you can see the charred part of it from the fire, and I don't know if the tree fully died or not, but like, you can tell that the bush is just not as thick as it once was. There you are. What are you doing? You blend in so well. Hi. Hi. Good evening. What are you doing? Yes. Let's go for a walk. Where should we walk? This way. Come on. Lucy. What are you doing? And here's another one of the cats. And that's definitely some kangaroos up there, I think. Also, here's a bunch of like broken glass and stuff from the old house that my mom salvaged. My mom used to make red light windows. So these are all parts of windows that she made, and I guess they're just sitting here in piles after, you know, melting together and whatnot. It's kind of cool. I feel like some kind of fun project could be done with the old things from the house. I came to try and find some kangaroos, but
I don't know where they went. If you follow me on Instagram, then you've probably seen all of the animals that I keep posting about. But every time I walk up to this part of the property, it just like, look at how brown it is. It is so dry and so crispy. And I don't think I've ever seen it so dry, except I want to say probably the season that the bushfire actually came through, but I wasn't here. And so I don't know what it was like, but it's scary. Like everything is so crisp. And you know that like if a spark happened, it would go up. So it's concerning going into summer and everything like that. It rained a little bit last night, but not enough to like do anything. But yeah, it's not good. Not good at all. But yeah, I think I'm gonna keep wandering around and then get into my night routine, I suppose.